Let me see a list.
Do you have to have a...
No.
Like if you...
No.
Bleach all your hair, you don't have to have a cap, do you?
No, you don't need to.
I can do it.
You don't need to pick ass up my cap, buddy. I give that. Oh, do a part?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes. And then G.
Yeah, and G sometimes.
You gotta practice that more G.
Chris, I live in North Carolina. I doubt you do. My friend Chris Halley was going, you know Elvis?
Winter's coming.
I doubt you do. You don't know any Elvis songs, do you?
Elvis songs? Oh, my Lord.
We have.
I doubt it.
I doubt it.
I used to play Love Me Tender, but I touched it. Elvis did a last song I played.
There's God over here that he's wanting to know if I'll play Elvis songs. I'm like, I
no, I don't think so.
But we had two Elvis gospel albums going in the house last week because somebody let it to us.
Oh, no, I know.
How about the
Neil?
He touched me, the Elvis album. It's pretty. Ruben had it.
I love this guy to death, but I said, no, that's not going well. Ever did bluegrass or old time music.
But he did some pretty good songs.
Yeah.
But I think, to me, he had too much orchestration going on. It drove me nuts. We were listening to it last week. I like to hear, you know, the actual.
His gospel stuff was really good, but you're right, he had too much in the background going
on. Too much going on in the background. Elvis's records that we were listening to last week. They kind of covered his voice. I like to hear an actual human voice.
Mm-hmm. I think his earlier stuff, they didn't do that. You could hear it.
You know, even I thought so, but then when I went back and listened to it, it had a lot of stuff going on, too.
Yeah. You never was an Elvis fan.
I liked his early hits.
I wasn't a fan of him either. It was like four songs I liked, and they're just
About right, yeah.
They're songs, and that's it.
Yeah.
I've had three girlfriends in my life, all of them like Elvis, and I'm just like, I can't stand Elvis because of that.
Try some of this.
Thank you.
Lady of the Lake.
Lady of the Lake, okay.
That Jack Newbeck got me messed up on that. He plays it a different way, and I can't play it the right way now.
Well, I learned that from listening to Benton. That's the way Benton did it.
Yeah.
It's a little different.
That's the way we always played it, the way Benton did it. Come Gerald's son.
That's right.
BJ?
Benton.
BJ, yeah.
That's
what I was. Yeah.
And then
Jack
Newbeck's got all of it, but just version
he's
got
messed
up. He might not
be right.
It's got some real
intervals.
He can
have a book
while he
plays.
A fork of you.
She was about to walk.
Fast. You want fast? Real fast. Okay.
The name
it. Sugar Hill Sailing. Ragtime Addict.
It's a good tune, you know. We need to
they
work.
They want something fast.
What's that?
Ragtime Addict.
Thank you.
Right.
Don't listen to her. She's just...
Well, that's true.
All right, with five of us, you need to get them amongst us. Yeah.
Oh, she's right, of course, but she's also bossy.
We could scoot.
Yeah, we will. If you don't come down, we'll come to you.
Yes.
Yeah. There you go. Well, maybe.
I don't know how that works. Some people have to have space.
Things sound better with a smaller number of people, too.
They do sometimes. Yeah.
Years ago, we tried to play Blanche's Kitchen, you know. They had a fiddler over here and a fiddler over here, and they weren't together at all. Oh, Lord have mercy. We just didn't know which path to go.
A lot of jams start out that way, and then people gradually improve.
Yep.
Yeah.